Hello gorgeous people, this is Chris from Recombu and I'm here with Huawei's new Morpho Aurora version of the P20 Pro. Fresh new colour, fresh new design for one of the best smartphones of 2018. So we're going to give it a quick unboxing and setup and everything, have a run through it all and show off that gorgeous sleek new design. So first of all, let's just pop it on out, and there is the Morpho Aurora version in all of its glory. Now essentially it's a subtle redesign of the original gradient finish, which I have on the original P20 Pro right here. So we can do a bit of a side-by-side comparison with them. As you can see, the original gorgeous gradient finish on the Huawei P20 Pro, it started off with this sort of purple colour up at the top, and then it sort of gradually morphs its way down to a lovely seductive sort of blue down here at the bottom. In the case of the new Morpho Aurora version of the P20 Pro, it's kind of reversed. You've got the blue coloration up at the top, and then as you can see, as you move down the smartphone, it morphs into more of the purpley color. There's actually hints of yellow and orange in there as well, and then it turns into a proper full-on black at the bottom. And of course, as with the original model, as you sort of tilt it and it catches the light in different ways, it throws up all kinds of different light spectrums. It looks absolutely stunning. Now, apparently this Morpho finish was inspired by the Morpho butterfly. I've got to admit, I'm not much of a butterfly fancier. I'm sure there's some posh poncy long word for that, which I'll flash up on screen now to show that I do occasionally do a little bit of research at least. I've got no idea what this Morpho butterfly looks like either, but I'll tell you what, I'll put the phone here and I'll flash up a picture of the butterfly there. And yeah, spot the difference, right? So apart from the change to the gradient finish, the Morpho Aurora P20 Pro basically rocks the same hardware and specs and everything as the original P20 Pro. So once again, you get this lovely sleek design glass all over the back with a nice bit of aluminium banding around the edges. As you can see, nice bit of highlighting on that power button just to help it really stand out. And of course, that triple lens tech mounted there on the back. And once again, you have a fingerprint sensor mounted here down beneath the screen, so you can quickly and easily get into your P20 Pro, although it of course supports really responsive facial recognition as well. It works even well in low light environments. Now, what else do you actually get in the Morpho Aurora P20 Pro's box? Well, it's basically the same setup as the original P20. As you can see here, Porky Pin device to actually get your SIM installed, always handy. And you do get a lovely bit of protective cover case action as well. And thankfully, it is a transparent cover case as well, because the last thing you want is to cover up that gorgeous Morpho Aurora finish, of course. So there you go, that just snaps on there, and as you can still see that lovely, gorgeous gradient finish through there, but it also adds a nice bit of protection so you don't accidentally crack and smash up your gorgeous P20 Pro. Besides that, it's just your standard stuff, really. You get, of course, an adapter. In this case, it's an Asian adapter because it came direct from Asia, this sample. You also, of course, get the charging cable and a bit of in-ear headphones as well, which can pretty much just be forgotten about. I'm just going to get it quickly set up now and then have a quick whiz around the interface and everything as well while we're here. So as before, it's a 6.1-inch smartphone. As you can see, a gorgeous OLED display with a full HD plus resolution. So nice and crisp and colourful for all of your media, your games, whatever you fancy doing on this thing. There is, of course, a bit of notch action up top, but fear ye not, if you're not a fan of notches, you can just dive into the display settings and there's all kinds of customization you can do in here thanks to Emotion UI 8. So one of those options is to knock off the notch. Basically all that does is just puts a black bar across the top of the screen, just masks it from view, and then bam. Emotion UI adds all kinds of other features, of course, as well. So once again, you get your smart assistant section, which for instance has the one-handed UI. Definitely very, very helpful indeed, because this is quite a sizable handset. So all you need to do to activate the one-handed mode is just swipe from the corner towards the center of the display, and there you go, straight into the one-handed mode. Now much easier to reach that notifications bar and everything else you need. And then just tap outside of it to go back to normal. As mentioned before, there's a fantastic bit of face unlock to bolster that fingerprint ID. Very, very handy if you're wearing gloves or your fingers are a bit greasy, something like that. As with the standard, Huawei P20 Pro is a Kirin 970 chipset running the show as well, backed by 6 gigs of RAM. So reasonably nippy, even though that Kirin 970 chipset is fast approaching its first birthday. So hopefully it'll continue to stand the test of time. Obviously it's been surpassed by the likes of the Snapdragon 845. But you can still play the likes of PUBG Mobile on top detail settings without any stammers or stutters. And this model has 128 gigs of storage as well, and sadly it's not expandable via microSD, which is a bit of a shame, although still plenty of room for all of your media and apps. As before, you get a 4000 mAh battery on there as well, which should keep you going for at least a day, probably closer to 2 days, depending on how much you use it. But even if you're gaming on it, using Skype, snapping away all day long, shooting your 4K videos, it'll still last you a day, no problem. But of course, one of the highlights of the P20 Pro is undoubtedly that tri-lens camera. You get a 40 megapixel f1.8 RGB lens backed by a 20 megapixel monochrome lens, and then a third telephoto lens, 8 megapixel with built-in OIS. Frankly, it's an absolutely stunning camera, definitely one of the best smartphone snappers of 2018. Go check out my full in-depth review of that camera right here on Recombu, and over on TechSpert, I've also done some comparisons between the P20 Pro and some of its biggest rivals of 2018. And you selfie fans haven't been forgotten either. Around the front, you get a 24 megapixel front facing camera as well to snap your mug. So that in a nutshell is a new Morpho Aurora P20 Pro. As you can see, it's basically the same hardware as before, but with a revamped finish right there on its glossy rear. Definitely stunning stuff. Let us know which version you prefer, this version or the original Gradient P20 Pro, which I have right here. Definitely be interested in your thoughts. Not a massive world of difference between them, but it's a slightly different option. And we do like the fact that it goes all the way from a lovely sort of like blue sky effect all the way down to a more earthy darkness down here. I'm sure some sort of Ponzi philosopher will tell you all about how it's supposed to reflect our inner selves, going from lightness to darkness, something like that. Frankly, it just looks really nice. We will of course be attending the Mate 20 launch when that kicks off in October, so stay tuned for our full hands-on impressions of those bad boys. And don't forget to hit subscribe for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech. Cheers, guys.